So I'm going to get the reflection on this boat in next. Which kind of comes in and then around the boat to the back. Then I can just shade that in. A similar idea. This time the shading will go out this way to the back of the boat, and then there's a small piece of shading to go just underneath where the waterline is. Can use the putty rubber just to knock out the white band. Running along this boat. And then I can put in the shadow or the reflection of this front rowing boat with the darker band around the edge. The under part of the hull in at the same time. Go crossways to get the front part of the bow in, and then we can say that it comes around this way and then back, changing the angle again. Hatchery there a little bit, and then this edge needs to go a lot darker. So it comes out and around. And then this can go darker as well. Okay, and then this little boat, we can shade him in. Just darken it up. It's actually pretty dark in this gap between the far boat and this little boat against the wall edge. And we've actually got a reflection in there. And then we're into the wall here. So I'm going to put a few bits of brick suggestion on the wall, and then I could just shade vertically just so that we get a more solid shape. And then these tires are going to be dark in the center. So it's just a little circle within a circle. So I'll shade through that one and then darken the center. And bring the tone all the way through the wall. Get that tire in. Just make the edge of it a little bit stronger so it stands out. Might give this tire a little white band just to make it a bit different. And shade through all of this up to the back of the little red boat. And actually on the red boat, I think it's the boat behind, but I'm going to put some of these shapes in just to break it up a bit. So then I can shade in some of these little gaps just to give the feeling that there's something on the back of that boat. Come down, just continue the shading downwards into the reflection. I'm just going to let this get lighter as it comes towards us. I'm not going to put the whole, worry about all of that because that'll be done with washes when we paint it. But I'm going to get the hull in of this little vessel. So then this needs to start to angle and then it will straighten up, coming all the way back to the back of the boat. And then the bottom, I'm just going to shade it at a more steep angle. To imply that it's tucking under. And then we've got a nice dark edge here. So pressing nice and hard. In the front, and then we can have a darker edge here as well. And then continue the shading all the way through the wall. And a little trick to keep a straight edge with the shadings, if you hold your pencil on the line, you can just shade up to the edge. And then you end up with a nice straight edge. Just put some tone through this bit. Come a bit higher. The edge out there, and then I can put the little window in just going to shade that in. And then just put a light piece of tone over the whiter part so that it all then becomes part of the shadowy area. And then I can go darker in here. Oops, snap my pencil, that was clever. Darker in here. There's a bit of an edge there. Just a little bit of detail there. I think there's a life buoy there or something. Of the boat, just get some of these buoys in. They're fairly round. And then just a bit of tone underneath the boat. Again, I'm not going to put all the reflection in because that will be painted. Break that up a bit. Putty rubber. And then there's a bit of tone reflection under this boat. So we can put that in. Make this one behind it a little bit darker as well. Keep this fairly light, this blue boat. And then these ones in the distance here, this needs to come down a little bit. Put the back of the boat in. This is the side of the boat. Just some tone through there. Maybe we'll create a line through it. A canopy in, little windows. And then there's some more little boats kind of here, but I don't want to put all those in. I'm just going to have a few shapes. So there's a shape there, and then maybe the front of a boat sort of here, coming relatively flat. To bring this wall down a little bit. Just overlap those little boats over the wall. Few little mast bits, a bit more tone through here, and also underneath this mast, bring the wall through, so that will then show up that beam. And then there'll be a reflection, a darker reflection in the water. So I can just put some tone through there for the wall. Back of this little boat. These will all have little reflections on them as well. Just make the backs a little bit darker. All the way through. Then I'll get into the roof line now. So there's a little building in here, comes through, lots of windows, just some little slits. Put some windows in this one. Keep them quite small, don't want the windows to be too big. Few more buildings here, like a garage or something. Another building there. A few little windows. And then we've got our wall that comes up. So then we'll just have some mound or sort of rockiness coming down this way. Just shade that in, give it some different direction. Then we've got our ladder, which is here. I'll shade that in a second. So this ladder has got little spaces in it. So just pop some of these in. Again down here. few more higher up. And then we've got a row of houses sort of through the back here, but again, they're not very detailed, so I might just let them fade out, just have a bit of tone through there. So then we got a few roofs, a few chimneys, the old chimney here and there, coming down. And then the odd change in angle. And then below that, just can put in a few windows, some little marks to suggest that they are buildings. Just some little dots kind of lined up. They need to be lined up, otherwise they won't look like windows. The odd dark doorway here and there. Then this sort of comes down and then disappears behind our crane. Got our little figures here, the odd car in the distance, or car-like shapes. That's fine. And then there's actually a house sticking out here, which is quite prominent, this one, so we need to get him in. It's going up there and then down. It's got a slope on the roof. Down, then we've got the little chimney here. We've actually got a row of buildings going behind this one. So this little house in front. Actually, I will make those all one row. So then that will be the roof line through there. And then we can have some more little windows. Some single dots, some double dots. And then we've got another little window here. A couple of vertical dots, one horizontal dot, gives the feeling of a larger lower window, and two smaller windows, panes above it. We'll have one more there. So that comes down, and then we've got another little building in the background here, which links this side to that side. And again, more chimneys. And little windows again. Crane itself has got, I don't know, it must be a motor or something on there, so we can put that on. There's some shapes back here, boxes. This looks like it's out got a kind of funny shape at the bottom. And then this front row of houses, we can get those in. A few windows again. So this comes across. Little angle there. Across here. And then there's the roof of this next building. Chimney, and then the next building, and chimney, going downhill then, and then come out at an angle, this one's got some little dormer windows, so I'll just put a little straight bit at the bottom. In there. Maybe add four little panes on these ones. And perhaps on this one as well, a few windows. Another one there. Maybe one more. And then down here, we've got the window for the van, which is pretty dark. Sort that roof out, that wasn't very good. Back. Let's be flatter. Comes down and in. We've got the wheel. A bit lower actually. Straighter here. And the second wheel, which should come in front of that, so I need to come forward a bit more. There's the second wheel, and then we're into the bonnet section. And there's another wheel under there somewhere. And then it's very dark anyway, so you can't really see what's going on. Then this is all dark. Little door handle. And there's some little windows in the background here. And another one here. And then this little figure can be quite dark, I think. He's had lots of chips, and he could be a narrow one. Okay, and then perhaps we could have a couple more little figures. Bit further away, just going about their business. Maybe another one over here, just to add a bit of life to the harbour scene. Another one there, and then there's another, I don't know, we'll put a big box or skip or something here at the edge of this building. There's more windows there on that side. There's actually a sign. It must be a shop or something. There's some scaffolding poles. And then there's another building coming in there, which we'll just ignore. So this is all in shadow. So So we can actually shade all this part in, leaving the building behind it nice and light. I imply that the shadow comes up that building a bit. There's vans in shadow. Some of these a bit darker. Just going to knock these back, just run some tone through these buildings. Just to give them bit of variation. Put the roof in. They don't all have to be filled in, you can leave some of them white. And then up on the hill line, again, I don't really want to put all these buildings in, I'm just going to have some roof lines, some straights, just a few little windows here and there. Because I'm thinking this is all going to be just a big wash coming down to the detail. So we just had the odd roof window here and there. A few more windows here and there. Maybe some on this building. And then maybe we could have a few more uprights, a bit taller, just to link it together. Oops, broke my pencil again, that's clever. Let's go to a 4B. So this can definitely have a bit more tone through the boat. So I'm going to shade it now crossways just to make it a bit darker. And then this is much, much darker, that front edge. And it comes round and then up the into the distance. A bit darker there. Stronger marks just to get it to stand forward a bit more. Maybe there's a bit of something inside the cabin. Some darker pieces here. The odd dark window in the distance there. Maybe there's a dark shape on top of the vessel. Little bits and pieces, ropes, wires. Maybe we could have a little figure on this boat leaning over. Give him a head, hands, standing in the boat. Perhaps he's got a friend up on here talking to him. Up on the edge there. He's got, I don't know, like a rope or something, a bit of wire, who knows. Okay, and then all of this will be dark when we come to paint it. This will be dark. And then obviously we'll get some little breaks in that with the lights from the houses in the distance. And in fact, all of this will be in the water, will be a lot darker. So we can just put a bit more tone through here. Just into the distance back there. Few little dark shapes. A few bits of detail in this under part of the building. Darker under that van. And then we'll just have a little bit of tone just to knock all this white down. Down, and then I could just take a putty rubber and just lift out some of the shapes just to suggest they're a little bit lighter. The odd white house in there. Stronger shapes here, edge of a building. On the edge of here, perhaps there's some poles there. Much darker under here. Oh, broken another pencil. Let's go to this one. And that's broken as well. A darker shape there. Few more darks into the brickwork. Darker down by the water line. Darker through there. Okay, I think that will do for the drawing. Ready for the painting to start next week.